Hi, I'm Andre from the John Morris Group, and today I'm here with Sven from Pipescan. His organization is located in Austria, and they manufacture a range of solutions for environmental monitoring of water quality. But today we're going to be looking at the Pipescan, which is a product aimed at potable water analysis in distributed networks. Hi, Sven.
Hi, Andre.
I'm wondering, Sven, if you can tell us a little bit about it. What is the purpose of the Pipescan?
So actually the Pipescan is a combination of different sensors, some ion selective electrodes or some optical sensors. And this combination actually benefits you that you can measure directly in one spot on a drinking water pipe, for example.
Right. And so why would a customer want to measure parameters on a drinking water pipe?
So normally the operators have to take samples and bring them to the lab, and it takes time. It's cost effective, time consumable, and so with the Pipescan you have a real-time online data. So at the moment you know directly the values of the water.
Right, but so don't most water authorities already measure the quality of their water at their drinking water facility? Why would they want this?
Mm-hmm. Sure, they normally do this, but they take samples or they have single probes. And the benefit of this is you have a combination of different parameters and different probes in one spot, actually.
So why does a drinking water facility want to know readings at a different location than their treatment facility? Yeah.
So actually, to get an overview about the distribution network, so they know normally the parameters of their treatment facility, but they do not actually know the data of the distribution network. So in different places, if there's a damage or if there's a leakage in the pipe, they can get contaminations in the system. And so they have a real-time online monitoring of the whole system, actually.
Okay, and so how does this fit on a pipe? How do you put this on a pipe?
So you can see there's a clamp settle at the bottom, and depending on the pipe size and the type of pipe the operator has, we can offer different clamp settles, and you fix it directly on the pipe. And so depending on a PVC pipe or a steel pipe, we offer different clamp settles for this.
Right, and do you have to turn the water network off while you're installing it?
No, actually you can install it in operation. So you put the clamp settle, then you can drill a hole in the pipe and then you separate the unit from the pipe, can do all the installations, and then actually you're running in a hot tap.
How much maintenance does a system like this require? I mean, it's got a lot of things happening here.
So actually the maintenance is very less depending on the probe you choose. If you have an ion selective probe, you have to replace it after 6 months, so it's a consumable. And the other probes, for example, the optical probes only need some cleaning. So in this case, we have a brush here, so mechanical cleaning. So maintenance is very less, actually.
So what kind of parameters can you monitor with a system like this?
So actually you can monitor with the optical probe the organic parameters like TOC, DOC. You can measure turbidity and color in the water. And with the other probes, you can have pH, for example, conductivity, free chlorine or total chlorine. So it really depends what the customer wants to measure.
Right. Okay. And what happens if the water in the network stops running? Does the system dry out or what happens?
No. So actually there's a nano pump in this unit which actually sucks the water into this flow cell. And if there's no water in the pipework, you still have water around the electrodes, so there will be no dry out of the electrodes.
Right, and so that's this little beast here, is it?
Yes, yes.
Right, I see. And so normally the pipe would be under pressure. So how do you service this without having to turn off your water network?
Yeah. So therefore we have a special tool. It's some kind of plate, and you actually put it between the measuring unit and the clamp settle. and so separate these two parts, and then you can change all the electrodes, or you can change cable or whatever you need, and then you remove this blade again, and then you are online again.
Right. So you remove the blade, and then you push down this zipper system back into the pipe.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. And so let's say that I don't trust the readings that are here. How could I collect a sample of the water for laboratory analysis?
Yeah. So therefore we have the possibility in this place, so you can take a sample actually from the same water you measure in this moment, and then you bring it to the lab, and then you have a reference value or for calibrating or whatever you need for.
So some locations I could imagine power might be an issue. What's the power options for this system?
So we can offer this in AC or DC, so depends what the client has available.
Does it take a lot of power?
Not really. So it also depends on the measuring cycle, how often you measure, how often the pump is running, how often the cleaning cycle is. Really depends on water conditions at site.
Right, okay. Let's say I want to have a couple of these located around, but I just want to have these saddle clamps. Can I remove all of this off the top and then just move it from site to site?
Sure. So if you have only this unit, then you can leave the saddle clamp on the pipe. You make it some kind of blind, and then you can remove the measuring unit to another clamp saddle and fix it there.
Okay. So in your mind, what's the key reason why water authorities are beginning to become interested in this product?
So the big benefits are that you have a lot of parameters, so up to 10 parameters in one spot, actually, all over your system if you have different locations, and it's real time, so it's the exact data at this moment.
Right, and where does the water go after it's been analyzed?
Mm-hmm.
And like, am I, is there chemistry, or what's going to happen?
There's no chemistry in, so it's only physical electrodes or optical. So the water passes the electrodes and no chemicals included. And the water, which has been sucked into this flow cell, goes back into the pipework after it passes the sensors.
So basically no waste.
No waste.
No chemical contamination. You said 10 parameters?
10 parameters.
Right. All at once?
All at once.
Wow. Thanks, Sven. I really appreciate you explaining to me the Pipescan from Scan. And there you have it. A fabulous new tool for analyzing water in your distributed network. If you've got any questions about the Pipescan or any other Scan products, please click on the link below and chat with our team in real time. Thanks so much for watching, and bye for now.